hurdle over the top there at the end of that one.
Not so much. First and goal, empty backfield. Stafford, quarterback draw, in for a touchdown. The first rushing touchdown of the season for Stafford and the 12th of his career.
What's going on, One Pride Riders? What's going on? Man, what a win. What a win. These Lions caught me by surprise out of nowhere, man. I did not expect them to win back-to-back games like that, dog. Like, I mean, that bad week has rejuvenated this team like a motherfucker, like. That bad we couldn't come at the right time, man. And the Raiders caught the Lions at the right wrong time, too. Oh, man, what a win, man. First of all, shout out to all the One Pride Riders, YouTube makers, my main man Beast Moores, 303 Hitman. Big shout out to 303 Hitman, man. You got a... Man, the Raiders was coming at you hard in them hate week videos, man. And I'm glad that you came away with the win at the end of the day, man. You was warning them all week about your team, man. So, good shit for you. East 1 LB, Everything King, all my commenters, man. And my ladies, female Lion fans, and everybody in between, man. So, you know, shout out to all of y'all, man. And, man, this is a... Really good win for us, man. It's good to be going into the Sheagles game. Thanksgiving, the game I'm going to, my first Lions game this season. That I'm going to, and I'm going to have a really good time with my main girls, Lindsay Lasanti and Yasmin Green. About to rock out with them, man. And, you know, it's going to be a good week, man. And, like, this shit three in a row. I tell you what, man, they beat the fucking Sheagles on Thursday, man. I'm gonna start believing in that 9-7. I think we need to win at least one more game. We need to go 5-7. We gotta beat the Packers at home, man. And then we're gonna have a lot of time in between the next game, which is the Rams game, and they ain't been looking too good lately. Dropping games to below 500 teams and shit lately. You know, they on a 3-game losing streak. So, I think that's a very winnable game as well. So, when you look at our second half schedule, we catch the teams at the right time, G. Like, we catch the teams when they really struggling right now. You know, and don't buy too much into that Packers win. I think that's still a struggling team, in my opinion. You know, they got a little break because I think it was more Minnesota who got ahead of themselves, man. I saw they got a little bit cocky coming into this game, man. In a way, even though I wanted the Packers to lose, I'm kind of happy they beat the Vikings because the Vikings need to come back down to earth, man. Like I said, they was getting a little bit too fucking cocky for their own good. You know, that's never good for a young team, man. You know, I think this game pretty much set them up, you know, to be a wild card team instead of winning the division, because that last game of the season, they got to go to Lambeau. So, you know, they ain't winning that motherfucker. Yeah, man, good win for the Lions, man. I set up a special little intro. I haven't done one of these in about a month or over a month, you know. I wanted to do something because when I was out in Oakland, you know, going to the Raiders-Jets game a few weeks ago. Me and my homie Killer Mike, you know, and his boys and his brother, we was watching this movie called Switchblade Sisters, which I ain't seen in a minute. It's one of my favorite movies of all time. And, you know, we had a selection movie. We was going to watch one of these gang movies, you know, the Warriors, you know, Switchblade Sisters. What were some other movies he had? He had some mobster movies in there, like Scarface and shit, and... Donnie Brasco, shit like that, Goodfellas. And I was like, man, let's watch Switchblade Sisters, man. I was like, shit, I ain't seen that shit in a long time, man. It'd be good to see that shit with the homies and see what they think, man, because I love that goddamn movie, man. I ain't seen it in a long time. And yeah, this is the first time I seen it in HD, so it looked it real clear. Because every time I saw this movie, this shit was at horrible-ass quality when I saw it before. But yeah, when I saw the movie, I forgot about the bitch with the patch. And it right away, Killer Mike brother was like, man, that's a fucking Raider right there, dog. The girl with the patch over her eye. I was like, hell yeah. So she got hers on the left eye, you know, the Raider. He got his on the right eye, you know what I'm saying? But I said, man, you know, I was thinking ever since. I said, man, maybe I'll use this in a preview video, a hate week video, something, man. But since I had to do one of those, I decided if the Lions win the game, I was going to do the clip at the end of the movie where the two girls who are the leaders, they fought each other and was trying to kill each other to get the spot at the top, you know, of their game, the Jezebel. So, you know, so I was like, you know, I was thinking of a scenario. I was like, man, this is actually correlate to the game. Like, the patch girl and the other girl was like Amari Cooper and Derek Carr. You know, they was the Raiders. They was representing the Raiders. They was in enemy territory because they didn't know the rest of the game was about to turn on their ass. So, what I did here was I made it where the other leader, and she was going to be Matthew Stafford, and the rest of the girls was going to be all Lions, like Lions offensive, defensive players, a mix of the motherfuckers. I said, they stepping out on the den, they stepping out on the turf. I said, this is excellent, man. I said, it couldn't be set up any more perfect for this video. So, big shout out to Lindsay, man. Can't wait to see you, baby girl, on Thursday, man. Thank you for this clip. She was able to get this clip because, she knows someone at one of the networks, the control center, and they had this movie in their library because they about to play real soon. They about to premiere it on their network real soon. So she was able to get it. That's how I been getting a lot of my videos from her, man. She got the connection, so to motherfuckers. So you know, that's part of her job and shit. So I was like, she working in the control center, and she was able to get this fucking clip for me, so I really thank you, baby girl, for giving me this shit, man, because this shit is awesome, man. So I'm going to go ahead and play this clip for y'all, then when I come back on the other side, you know, we're going to recap this game real quick, and then we're going to talk about these fucking Sheagles, and we'll be done. So let's get to it, man. Let's get to it, y'all. Let's go.
CBS Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
You must feel, man. You've been through so damn much lately. And here I am, your best friend, yelling at you. I'm sorry, all right? Okay. Now listen. Both of them are ready. All you have to do is make your move. And the rest will go along once they see you're on top again.
That's right.
Oh, here. Let me help you fix your hair. You gotta look good for this.
Mm-hmm. for you. Hi, Lace. You feeling better?
Feeling just fine, buddy.
Oh, good. We've been waiting for you. Hey, did you see our cake?
Hey, Donut. How you been?
Hi, Lace.
Still friends?
Yeah, sure. Still friends.
What's that for?
I was just getting this for Maggie.
Well, get me one. You heard me.
Okay. You can, have this one.
Hey, Hero, why so glum?
Just thinking about something.
Yeah? What?
Patch didn't shoot crabs by mistake. She had another reason.
Such as?
I don't know. Do you?
Listen up, everybody. I got a surprise for you. Me and Maggie here have been through a lot of scrapes in the past few weeks, and she's mean, and she's tough, and she's bad. And each of us owe her something in our own special way. Me? I owe her more than any of you. And that's why I have this surprise that I just found out about for sure last night. Our own little Maggie here is a fucking traitor!
What are you doing, Wade?
She spilled our attack plan to crabs and got Dominic killed. Then she tries to take over the gang. It was an ambush, man. She set the whole thing up.
That can't be true. Nobody fought better than her.
Yeah, she even saved your ass, Lace.
Yeah, she did that to cover herself, man. She was Crab's girl all along. We checked.
I don't believe it.
You knew it too, didn't you, Donut? Maggie told you all about it, didn't she?
Well, I guess so, Lace. I mean, I think I remember something like that.
And that's how she got the medallion so easy, wasn't it? Crabs gave it to her so Dominic would fall for the whole story. Ain't that so?
Yeah. I guess so.
That's not true. Let me up.
Let her talk.
She'll talk, all right. And she'll tell the truth.
It was you, wasn't it? You and Patch.
Why, Lace? Why? When I say so.
It won't work anymore, Lace. Walk soft, honey.
What was that?
She said it's no good. We're not buying it. Not from you or Donut either.
I didn't mean it. They made me say it. I'm sorry.
You're through, Lace. You're out.
I'm out.
That's what I said.
Okay, you want me out? You're gonna have to fight me. Or anybody else who's got enough guts to take me on. About you, Jenny. Got a pretty face that'd look real good with a big scar. What about you, Donut? Want me to slice off some of that extra blubber?
I'm sorry.
Come on, who's got the guts to try it? Come on.
I will.
Okay, Maggie.
Don't be shy. You were never shy with Dom, were you?
So, that's it, ain't it? You got your man killed because you couldn't hold him.
And I'd kill him again to keep him from you.
You know something funny, Lace? You were wrong. There was nothing between me and Dom. It was all you.
Liar! You had it!
Covered. Now let's go in and bust them.
Oh, wait a minute. They're fighting among themselves. If someone gets killed, we'll finally have a charge that'll stick.
You're all heart, aren't you, Rizzo?
It's murder, honey. You play by my rules. You're nobody now.
We're the Jezebels.
Stop
that, so.
Stop it.
I thought there were no gangs around here. What about you?
Jezebels.
And you?
Jezebel.
Jezebels.
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 What about you?
She ain't with us.
Sure I am. I always been.
I don't know her.
That's right. Don't know her.
I don't know.
She's not
her?
One of us. Never seen her before.
She ain't one of us.
Okay, Jezebel.
Give you some advice.
No. Let me give you some advice, cop. You can beat us, chain us, lock us up. But we're gonna be back! Understand? And when we do, cop, you better keep your ass off our turf, or we'll blow it up! You dig? Jezebel, cop. Remember that name. We'll be back!
Ah!
Yeah, so that's Switchblade Sisters, man. So if y'all want to check the rest of that movie out, it is one of my favorites of all time, man. Like I said, I just love gangster movies. So it don't matter what it is, monster movies, I just love them fucking movies. So, but that's one of my favorites, man. Top 10 favorites of all time, man. I saw that movie like a long ass fucking time ago, then. So it again this year. So yeah, but this game, man. Man, y'all know this is the Ace Taker Bowl, man. Y'all know me, man. Lions in Raiders fan. So you know it's hard for me to kind of. You know, I was going for the Lions all the way, obviously. That's my first team. First team, man. So, I was rooting for them guys. So, it was hard to root against the Raiders. But, man, that's why I'm so glad these teams don't face each other for, like, another 4 years. So, I don't got to go through that shit. Because it was kind of tough. I mean, at the same time, it was tough seeing the Raiders lose a game that they really needed. Because, I honestly think they ain't going to the playoffs. I've been saying that since the Jets game. Even though they beat the Jets, I've been saying they not going to make the fucking playoffs. Not this year. You know, they're going to have a good run in the AFC start next year, though. But they're going to make it there next year. They should be able to win the division next year. Because everybody else going to die off, man. Chiefs ain't really going nowhere. They got a veteran, late team. We know the Broncos pretty much are one and done this year. Like, they putting all their eggs into their basket this year. Don't get fooled with Brock Osweiler. That shit ain't lasting long, man. That dude is not the future of that fucking team. And plus, I think they losing a really key player. That's the key to leave. He gonna go somewhere else in free agency, man. So when they lose him, that's it for their ass, man. He been really saving their ass on defense. But yeah, man. This game, man, was. It's amazing because the Lions been averaging 18 points a game and they ended up with 18 the last couple of weeks. So 18 is our magic number right now. That we got to get the 18 in order to win, I guess, man. it's been amazing that way, man. But this team, man, I tell you what, man, this defense came back hard as hell. I got three key players on this team this week. In probably the last couple of weeks. That's been Matthew Stafford, obviously, because the nigga been moving his feet the last couple of weeks, and you've been seeing him coming up through the clutch. Now, his games ain't been pretty all the way through, but one thing Stafford been doing lately, he been moving his fucking feet, and we know when he does that, he has better success, so he needs to stick to that formula, man. He was running this shit today. I was like, man, Stafford really wanted to get this fucking win. And it's really been looking that way lately. Like, he's been having this killer instinct about him lately, like, where he just want to fucking come through in the clutch and shit and kill these teams, man. And if he can keep that attitude up, man, we're going to be winning in no time. So, it starts with him. It starts to end with Stafford when we get these wins. So, you know, he got to keep that shit up. You know what I'm saying? My second star is obviously Ziggy Ansah. I mean, this guy is awesome, man. I mean, this dude is literally my favorite player in the whole entire league right now. I think, you know, it almost would be Amari Cooper because I like this kid a lot, and I'm going to get into it when I talk about Slay. But, man, Ziggy Ansah, man, is like, because he was a complete project player. I mean, he lived in fucking Africa for almost 20, his first 20 fucking years of his life, man. This nigga didn't know nothing about NFL football. And this dude came over here and excelled so fucking fast, learned the game, and just became a monster. Like, he learned the game so fucking, like, people don't realize how quickly he learned the fucking game. Like, and you know, in his country, soccer is king, dude. Like, in Ghana, soccer is king over there, man. So, you know, for him to come over here and get used to American-style football is just fucking amazing. I mean, that's why he's one of my favorite players, because he's a guy that was a complete project. He was not expected to be as good as he is, and he's showing it. So, between him and Levy, like, Levy, I mean, Levy knew about the game, but the thing with Levy was he started out so fucking trash with the Lions, and then he just became an awesome player the last few years. You know, shame that he got hurt this season, but the two guys right there, man, I'm just so impressed with these guys, man. And obviously my number three star of the game, man, is obviously Darius fucking Slay. You want to talk about turnarounds. This nigga first half was so fucking trash that I started doubting this nigga going forward. But his struggles in the first half told me one fucking thing about him. He had lost his confidence in the first half of the season. He lost his confidence and he got it back these last couple of weeks because he been shut down corner last couple of weeks. Think about it. He shut down Amari Cooper today. That's why the Raiders only put up 13 today, man. You know, goddamn Raiders. The Raiders could have easily came in here and put up 30. Amari could have had a couple of them fucking touchdowns today. This nigga only had one catch, I believe, Amari Cooper. This nigga been beasting on every other corner in the game except this one, Darius Slay. That's why he got the nickname Big Game Slay, because, you know, I was, for the longest in the first half, I was saying, like, his name is Big Game Slay because other motherfuckers be having big games on his ass. But we know why he named Big Game Slay, man. That's the reason why, man. And even though he got hurt a little bit in the game today, he looked a little bit more healthier, too. I think that he was battling an injury, and it slowed down his speed a little bit against some of these receivers. But, man, Terrell Austin, this is why I said, man, he's one of the best defensive coordinators in the league right now, man. We took him for granted this season in the first half because we were struggling so much, and I never gave up on him. I kept telling people, I really hope we keep this dude next season. I kept on telling people, like, do not take Terrell Austin for granted because he ain't going to be here one day. And we don't know if our defense is going to be trash without him, you know, and that's the scariest thing to think about. So, the last couple of games were defensive wins, man. I mean, think about this fucking team, man. We don't got that much fucking talent on defense if we've been winning these last two games. That's all coaching right there. That's all coaching. When you don't got the fucking players and you could come up with defensive games like this, that's all coaching, man. That's all fucking coaching, dude. So, it's definitely been looking good. I think Jim Valcooter so far has definitely been better than Lombardi. Definitely been better. I can see his game plan coming a bit to life. His game plan is a lot more different than Lombardi. I've already seen out of gate. I've barely seen a lot of those screen calls. He's got Stafford moving his feet more in the pocket. It's looking like, man, dude, if we would have had Jim Valcooter as the offensive coordinator the whole season, we'd probably be about 5-5 right now instead of 3-7, man. We probably would have won a couple of those games that we lost due to Lombardi if we had Jim Valcooter in there. Now, the one negative about this game, and I'm pretty sure it's everybody's big negative about today's game, and that's fucking Eric Ebron. Fucking Ebron, dude. This motherfucker is... I'm starting to lose confidence in this nigga. Because he was looking better earlier in the season. He was looking like he turned it around. And then today, it wasn't just the drop, okay? That was a big-ass drop in the end zone today, okay? Because, like I said, Matthew Stafford should have had at least one or two passing touchdowns today. One of them was on Stafford and the other one was on Ebron. But, in my opinion, Ebron, the biggest problem I had, he ain't showing no fucking effort. And I got a big problem when players don't show fucking effort. Now, you could drop the ball, but you better show some fucking effort. And Ebron did not show that. Ebron, you better grow the fuck up, dude. Because you, right now, are playing like your fucking age, dude. You really are, dude. You need to cut that shit out and fucking play. Now, I've been saying this for about another week or two now. We need a white tight end in the draft. We need to draft a white tight end because we need, and it's not just drafting a white tight end per se. It's because I know most of the white tight ends in the league have good fucking hands. We need to get someone. That's why I didn't want to get rid of Fourier, because I don't know why he ain't on this fucking team right now. I know he had injury problems, but he should be on this fucking team right now because our struggles in the red zone this season has been has had a lot to do with not having fucking Fourier in there. Fourier probably should have been, that play that was drawn for Ebron should have been fucking Fourier. Fourier would have caught that bitch. He would have caught that bitch. That's a big ass target. Like, dude, why? I mean, why ain't he on this fucking team? I got a big problem with that shit. And I knew that shit was, it almost cost us the game today. If the Raiders came in here and won. I said it, man. It's going to be two games this season that's going to cost us because fucking Fourier ain't on this fucking team right now. It's going to be a game or two where we don't execute in the red zone and we could have had fucking Fourier. And look, this was almost 1-0. This was almost 1-0. Two fucking red zone opportunities failed. So, because when you think about it, we don't really have good red zone targets. Like, Calvin Johnson, Tate, these guys are like stretch the field receivers, man. They're not really goal line targets, man. Goal line targets are usually your tight ends and running backs and shit like that, dog. We don't have that shit right now. Theo Riddick is probably the closest thing we got right now to that. But, man, like I said, we do a better job probably running the football when we get in the red zone instead of throwing it. Also, Caldwell, what the fuck are you doing too, man? Like, nigga, you fucking, it's late in the game. This nigga, it was one of the possessions that we had when it was like 8 minutes to go, I believe. And this nigga did not run the football one fucking time. Why was he fucking passing instead of eking time off the clock? You know damn well with one fucking pass, he's so damn lucky Carr was off his game today. Because if Carr had one of them games, the monster fucking games passing wise, Raiders would have came down there and scored and won the fucking game, dog. 21-20-18 or some shit. 19-18. And they didn't get the, they probably would have tried the 2-point conversion. And that failed on them. So, but the good thing that Caldwell did do was that he had Prater out there kicking those field goals, those first three field goals. That made a huge difference because we were able to get some kind of points out of those failed red zone opportunities. Because we were getting to Oakland's zone a lot today. Our worst quarter of the game today was really the third. But the rest of the game, man, we were attacking them. And obviously, the biggest beast play of the game was the Ziggy Ansah safety, man. I mean, this guy's a fucking beast, man. But we were lucky that defensive call wasn't called on that same exact play, man. So, Lions fans have a lot to be happy about in that regard. So, man, I mean, this was an impressive win, man. Impressive fucking win. Like I said, I don't need high scoring games to be happy, man. I just need the team to fucking win it. I don't care how you do it, just fucking win. Actually, at this juncture, I wouldn't mind defensive wins because, you know, that means you're keeping the other team from scoring. And I think this team has a hell of a lot of confidence from that Green Bay game. I really think they do. I think they really have gotten confidence, man. I think that was a really good win up there in Lambeau. I think they kind of feel like they could beat anybody now, man. Honestly, I can't wait for this game coming up, dude. oh my God, y'all just don't know, man. If there was one game me and my buddy was talking about going to back in the preseason, we said we're going to this Thanksgiving game against the fucking Sheagles, man. We're going to this game. Let me play this quick little clip, man. It's one of the funniest clips I've seen all day. And this dude is fucking funny as hell. His name is Eat That Pussy 445, one of the biggest Eagle fans you'll ever see in your fucking life. This dude, his team played like such trash today. And aren't we lucky Sam Bradford ain't going to play in this motherfucking game coming up. We caught the Eagles at the right fucking time, man. Let me go ahead and play this clip now. I'll finish this video, man.
Hey, Chip, let me ask you a fucking question that I'm pretty sure the entire goddamn Eagles fan base would like to ask you, motherfucker. And I hope they skin your fucking bitch ass alive at that fucking bullshit ass press conference your punk motherfucking ass is gonna be giving at the end of this game. Let me ask you this. How in the fuck do you let a motherfucking rookie quarterback known as Jameis Winston from Florida State let him march his punk motherfucking rookie ass in our motherfucking stadium, home field? Motherfucker, you took a goddamn oath to defend this motherfucking turf against all motherfucking enemies, foreign and goddamn domestic, nigga. And you let this punk motherfucking bitch, Jameis Winston, come into our motherfucking house and drop 5 fucking touchdown passes on us. Setting a goddamn rookie record, tying it, setting it, I don't fucking know. 45-17, motherfucker, and you just sitting there on the sideline with that bitch ass ugly motherfucking look you got on your face. I'd have get on a plane right now to Philly and suck you in your motherfucking mouth, bitch. I'd have leave your motherfucking punk ass leaking all over that motherfucking Xfinity Live. I'd have bust you square in your motherfucking mouth, bitch. I'd have knock all your motherfucking teeth out. Leave your punk motherfucking ass leaking out up in the middle of the street, bitch. That's on some real motherfucking shit. And as a matter of fact, Chip, take Billy Davis, that punk-ass motherfucking redneck snorting, I want to sit back and skin deer on my motherfucking farm and shove carrots up the motherfucker's cornhole and shit. Take that mark-ass motherfucker with you. Take that motherfucker, take the whole motherfucking coaching staff with you, bitch. We don't want you here in Philly no more, my nigga. Get the fuck out of here, bitch. Fuck you and them hoe-ass niggas you with. Let me get to the fucking game. Mark Sanchez, you're a fucking bitch. I don't know how the fuck you're still on this goddamn team, but we trade Nick Foles and we keep Mark Sanchez. Now, how the fuck does that work? Stuttering like a bitch. How the fuck does that work, Chip? Huh? You get rid of Nick Foles, but you keep Mark Sanchez, that turnover motherfucker, that fraud-ass motherfucker, that motherfucking bean-eating, frijole-flipping motherfucker. Nigga, you want to go to the motherfucking taco truck? Mark, you want to go to the taco truck and get some motherfucking salito? Nigga, some ceviche, some fucking chorizo? You want some of that fucking shit? Oh, EDP, you're a racist motherfucker. Motherfucker, I said the same thing about motherfucking, Todd Bowles. That blacker than... I can't even talk straight. That blacker than asphalt motherfucker when he was our interim defensive coordinator. Ask that punk motherfucker if he wants to go to Popeye's, my nigga, and get him some goddamn biscuits and shit. Greasy ass fingers matching that greasy ass motherfucking black, shinier than a motherfucking tar baby ass goddamn head of his. Mark Sanchez, you're a bitch, dude. You how the fuck, nigga, I think you threw 3 picks. How the fuck do you throw a garbage time pick is beyond me, my nigga, okay? You come in here, Mark Sanchez throws a pick 6 at the end of the game to seal it, 45-17. We get our ass trounced on at home. Defense can't stop a motherfucking nosebleed. This sorry ass defense is letting motherfuckers off the line of scrimmage easy as fuck. Ain't even challenging the niggas. You feel me? Oh, and by the way, Mike Evans, shout out to you, my nigga, because you made this defense look like a motherfucking fool, just like all the other goddamn... Just like all the other motherfucking teams love doing. My nigga Jameis Winston, he drops back, throws a fucking pass. I think like a 40-yard fucking 20-25-yard pass to fucking Mike Evans, catches the ball. 3 fucking Eagles are right there just looking. What the fuck, bro? Where's that motherfucker? Oh, what's that black thing in the air? Is that a football? No, it's your motherfucking head, bitch, that I'ma kick off with my size 15 motherfucking shoe, bitch. You like that shit? Just looking and shit. I wonder what that fucking brown thing is. That oval. Looking like a silly, clumsy-ass, goofy, clown-ass-looking fucking bitch. Yeah, that's right, Byron Maxwell. You too, you punk-ass motherfucker. You fucking bust-ass motherfucking free agency-ass nigga. This team is a fucking disgrace, man. It's a fucking disgrace, dude. We fall to 4-6. What a garbage-ass motherfucking team this is, dude. And the way I see it, when Chip Kelly came here in 2013, he took the Eagles to the fucking playoffs, right? With Andy Reid's fucking players. Well, you can't really say it was all Andy Reid, you know, because Chip Kelly implemented... Yeah, I know the motherfucking implemented his goddamn system. I know the motherfucking implemented, nigga, that flawed-ass fucking broke-down-ass fucking system. Look at the system now, motherfucker. Look at the system now. That system fucking sucks motherfucking cock, nigga. The shit has been fucking exposed. It's been fucking exposed, my nigga. God fucking damn. You got DeMarco Murray running the goddamn ball. I think it's fucking east and west on some LeSean McCoy shit. And DeMarco Murray is a north and south runner. Plug it up the fucking hole on some Adrian Peterson type shit. You trade the whole motherfucking roster, Chip. And now you got some sorry ass motherfucking team. Nigga, that was worse than what the fuck they were last year. But everybody want to sit back and, oh my God, Chip Kelly, give him another year. You know what? Fuck Chip Kelly. Him and his motherfucking niggas he bought in. Fuck you, Chip. Get the fuck out of goddamn Philly. I don't give a fuck who the fuck hears me outside. Get this butterbean looking motherfucker the fuck out of here. Fuck this bitch, man. Talking about, you can't fire Chip. He bought a house in Philly. Motherfucker, I will take a fucking match and a bucket of gasoline and I will light that motherfucker on fire with that punk ass motherfucker in it. I don't give a fuck about your house, nigga. You a motherfucking millionaire. Fuck you in your goddamn house. I'll burn that motherfucker down to the ground, motherfucker, and won't think twice about that shit. Defense looking like a bunch of scrub-ass motherfuckers, man. Only thing that's fucking good, somewhat good about this goddamn defense, what, the defensive line? What, three motherfuckers? Because we run a 3-4, Fletcher Cox, Benny Logan, and what's the other motherfucker? Cedric Thornton? Connor Barron, I got his jersey looking like a fucking bitch out there also. What's up, Connor? I fuck with you, my nigga, but you looking like a motherfucking bitch-ass pussy motherfucker out there also, dude. Nigga dropped two motherfucking picks, dude. One of them could have been a pick six, nigga, and you dropped the bitch. I know goddamn well, nigga, you don't play motherfucking deep. You don't play offense, nigga, but you looking like a bitch also. How the fuck is a ball right in your motherfucking hands, nigga, and you still drop it? I know you're not a receiver, but goddamn, nigga, it's right in your fucking hands and you still drop it, cuz? On everything, blood got me fucked up, man. Get Mark Sanchez the fuck out of here, okay? Get Riley Cooper out of here. Gut this whole motherfucking team. My nigga Delia, I called her my nigga Delia, and she's all like, no, I think you got, huge shout out to her. Oh, you gotta give Chip another fucking year. Yeah, da, 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 da. Hey, fuck giving that nigga another year. You smell me? Fuck that nigga and him and the motherfucking hoe ass niggas he bought in this bitch. Because we fucking suck right now, dude. His goddamn system is flawed, exposed. It's a piece of fucking shit. You try to bring a goddamn college-type motherfucking offense up in the league, that shit ain't gonna work. My nigga Delia, this is the motherfucking pros, my nigga. This is the big leagues. This ain't no bullshit ass motherfucking Pop Warner shit. You feel me? Fuck it, I'm done. I'm done. Fuck this team, dude.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5! Eagle
Pride! Now remember, Stanley, Rebecca is bringing her new boyfriend over to watch the Eagles play. Don't let your emotions get the best of you while you watch the game. There's no need to embarrass your daughter in front of her guests.
Yeah, whatever.
I'm sure he's a nice young man. Apparently, he was born and raised in South Philadelphia.
Well, that sounds fine, dear.
Mom, Dad, I want you to meet Neon, Too Tall, Tony Aikman. He's my new boyfriend.
You can all call me the Playmaker for short. Nice to meet you all. South Philly in the house! So, are we ready to watch some football? How about them cats?
Rebecca, you should have known better.
It's okay, honey. We all make mistakes in life. You'll find another boyfriend. Just make sure he's an Eagles fan.
Fly, Eagles, fly, on the road to victory.
E-N-T-L-E-S, Eagles!
I'm just thankful for life.
I'm thankful for my family, I guess. That's what I'm always thankful for.
I know something that I am very thankful for. Heath bars, Butterfingers, and hot tamales.
I'm thankful for my family and friends.
I'm thankful for my son.
I'm thankful for American tackle football.
I'm thankful for all the great Eagles fans cheering us on to beat Dallas. Beat Dallas. Beat Dallas. Beat Dallas. Beat Dallas.
Organization is embarrassing, man. I mean, I got no fucking respect for the Sheagles franchise, dude. This is probably one franchise I really don't got no fucking respect for, like, outside of the division, man. I mean, this fucking franchise is trash, my nigga. Very trash. I just gave you a few examples right before this of how trash the fan is. It's man, as bad as as shitty as teams are, man, the fans, I think, make it even worse, man. Like, this is the worst fan base in the league, man. They got some trashy ass fucking fans, dude. Real talk, real trash ass motherfucking fans, dog. Man, dude, I think out of all the fucking wins we have this season, the one I'd be really happy about is if we could beat these motherfuckers on Thanksgiving, dog. Especially, man, dude, I've been wanting to beat these motherfuckers ever since we lost these niggas 2 years ago in that fucking snow game, dog. Because that game pissed me off so fucking much, man. So fucking much, man. And that was actually the first time I saw Man Beast's video. I remember he went off after that fucking game, man. I shared so much passion in that video with him, man. Like, I was so fucking mad we lost that game, dog. And that was the continued downward spiral we were in at the time. Man, where we just choked the goddamn season, man. But the good thing, man, the only good thing to really come out of that fucking season was when we beat the Bears on the road that season, the game I went to, was the last time I've been to Soldier Field. And fucking, when I met Lindsey Lisanti at the Ravens game on Monday Night Football. So, those are the only two good things to come out of that season, because one of my favorite coaches, man, Jim Schwartz, got fired that fucking season, man. So, that season's sort of like a real dark black eye, man. I hate that fucking season, dog. Oh my God. Ah, bad memories, man. So hopefully we can beat these motherfuckers like when we beat them on the road the season before that, man. And we finally got these motherfuckers in our house. And just embarrass their ass on Thanksgiving, man. That's what this game is all about coming up, man. This team ain't really got nothing going for them, man. Somehow, some way, they still in the playoff pitch because of their sad ass fucking division. I mean, every fucking team. At this point, I'm giving the Cowboys a real good shot to fucking win that motherfucker because now that Romo's back, they might got a chance now. You know, and they 3-7 just like we are. So there's a chance. There's a chance. It's fucking pathetic, but I mean, I, at the same time, I feel bad for Eagles fans as well because, I mean, Chip Kelly really set that franchise back like 3 to 5 fucking years, man. I mean, he really did. That was a shitty ass fucking hire. I don't know what the Eagles were thinking when they hired Chip Kelly. This is why I like to stay away from college fucking coaches, man. They just do not, most of them do not translate well to the NFL. I hope the Lions, at this point, though, I'm going to be real honest. If it's not Jim Harbaugh coming in here, if it's not Jim Harbaugh, I'd rather do Keith Caldwell. That's how bad it is right now, to be honest with you. So, I mean, Chip Kelly, like I said, he really screwed that fucking team up, and the defense is sorry as fuck. I forgot what they one fucking defender name is. The guy who intercepted that pass in the Dallas game, their last win. When he was out for the rest of the season, I knew it was doom and gloom for this team after that. It's fucking Sam Bradford. So, look, there's no excuse for the Lions to lose this one. Now, I'm going to be royally pissed, especially being at the game if they lose this motherfucker. Because there's no fucking excuse to lose this fucking game. I give you every excuse in the world if you lose the next game against the Packers. You know, I give you every excuse in the world if you lose that fucking game. But you cannot lose this one. This is the one I want really badly, and they better not fucking lose it, dog. I'm going to be so fucking pissed if they lose this fucking game. So, I mean, I want another EDP rant just like that so I can show that his rant in the next video. Him ranting after he maxes off of Thanksgiving food and shit. You know, let's see his fucking reaction. I mean, man, that's one of my favorite YouTubers to watch over here, man. It's quite a few of these motherfuckers over here that's just comical and cartoonish, man. Like, another one is El Presidor, man. He's a Cleveland Brown fan. Catch his fucking videos too, dude. That dude is a clown too, man. It's so many fucking clowns on YouTube, man. A lot of them in the TTC too, man. It's some clowns in there, man. But yeah, man. I really can't wait to just be at this game, be with my girls, Lizzie Lasanti and Yasmin Green. And by the way, Yasmin, because I know you was telling me earlier you found this dude who rewrote the lyrics of the Eagles fight song, and you wanted me to sing it, so I'm gonna go ahead and sing it. Let me pull it up first, cause I know the Eagles fight song by heart, but like I still need to look at it because the lyrics are different. So let me sing this one for right now, man. And we're gonna be singing this shit at the game on fucking Thursday. And like I said, man, before I start singing this, man, I dare a motherfucking Sheagle fan to fuck with any of us at this fucking game. Now you on our turf now, bitches. You better not say shit. You better keep your ass quiet at this fucking game. You ain't in Philly right now with your fucking lame ass fucking South Philly wannabe bully fucking fan base, dog. You in our house now, so I dare one of y'all motherfuckers to start some shit, you know. Because the last time I went to an Eagles game for a field, they did try to start some shit, some of them Eagle fans. So don't try to come in here thinking y'all at Lincoln Financial Field, motherfucker. Y'all on our turf now, not the niggas. You know what I'm saying? If you don't start that shit, I'll ruin your fucking Thanksgiving Day, motherfuckers. And your trip to fucking Detroit. So y'all better calm that shit down right fucking now. I can't stand this fucking fan base, man. And I really want to stick it to this one motherfucker I'll be in the chat room with every fucking Monday night, man. This motherfucker, I'm finna really stick it to this motherfucker this week. I'm finna really get it, give it to him this week. Now, this, for me, this is a definite hate week for me right here, man. This the one I've been waiting on, dog. This the fucking hate week I've been waiting on. So, man, how the hell you lose a tap on 45-17? I still can't believe that shit. How the fuck you lose a Tampa like that, man? Oh my god. Let me see this song, man. Matter of fact, hold on, man. I need to watch the Eagles fight song video real quick just to kind of do this shit right, man. I want to do this shit right, man. I'm not a great singer, so I want to do this shit right. Hold on, man. Let's do this. Doom, 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 cry, she goes cry, on a road to misery, sigh, she goes sigh, blow the big games, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, miss them low, loft them high, and watch our egos die, dun, 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 bye, she goes bye. On the road to misery, bridesmaids of the NFC. Whoever made these goddamn lyrics are fucking genius, man. Oh my god, dude! I'll tell you what, man. When every time the Lions fucking score or the Eagles just fuck up, me and Anthony gonna swing this shit so fucking loud, dude. We're going to sing this shit so fucking loud, dog. I mean, we're going to have some fun with this shit, man. I mean, look at the lyrics, man. Cry, she goes cry, on the road to misery. Sigh, she goes sigh, blow the big games, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, miss them low, loft them high, and watch our egos die, dun 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 dun, bye, she goes by, on the road to misery, bridesmaids of the NFC. Oh man, y'all can tell I can't wait for this fucking game, man. Only 3 days away, man. Be back in the fucking D for the first half of this season. We gonna defend the den, dude. Like, we on the two-game winning streak on Thanksgiving right now. And we're gonna continue this shit. We're gonna continue it. We're gonna continue this win streak on Thanksgiving, dog. This team is feeling themselves right now. They know they just need to win out. They make, you know, get themselves a chance next Thursday. Big showdown. A game that wasn't looking like shit this Thursday night football game against the Packers. We can do it. Like I said, we probably going to that game too, man. Because, like I said, man, I ain't gonna be able to hang out the whole fucking day. I gotta be back home for work later on that night. So we really thinking about making a night of it, man, and going to this fucking Packers game and really doing the shit justice, man. But the only bad thing, man, I'm not sure we winning that game or not. You know what I'm saying? But hey, ain't things possible, man? We can go 5-7, dog. Like, the shit is possible, man. So anything is possible right now, man. And like I said, you know, we're proving right now there's no point of a rebuild. No point at all of a rebuild. We just need to plug in some motherfuckers. Like I was saying, I went over this in detail last week. Not going to do that this week because I'm about to wrap up this video. Like I said, we just need to plug in some motherfuckers because the secondary been stepping up. Slay and them boys, Quandre Diggs. The best thing to happen was Rasheem Mathis' injury, man, because the young boys been stepping up in that fucking secondary, dog. Nevin Lawson, you know what I'm saying? These other dudes, Abdul Qadis, all these guys, man, they've been stepping up in that fucking secondary. That's been the big difference, man. You talk about one of the best passing attacks the last couple of weeks getting shut the fuck down, dog. And I can't imagine. The only way the Eagles gonna have a good pass game on us is if we take them for granted early in the game, man. If we take the fucking Sheagles for granted at any point in this fucking game, they're going to take advantage of that shit. So we still got to kind of keep our toes up, man. We got to come into this shit acting like, you know, the last couple of weeks, man. Because I think we're going to be favored in this game to win, dude. Like, we haven't been favored to win in a very long time. So, you know, we're going to be favored to win and do this shit. And I'm not, dude, if you're a real fucking Lion fan, you just want to see your team fucking win. Don't worry about the fucking draft picks right now. Like, motherfuckers talking about, man, we need to tank, man. I don't like all these wins right now. What's the point of rooting for your team if you don't want them to fucking win? You know what I'm saying? Stupid ass motherfucker. This is not even a team that needs a rebuild, man. I mean, you know what I'm saying? This team just needs to keep fucking winning. They need to plug in some motherfuckers next year in the draft. Like I said, I stick back to what I want. Defense. If we could get one of these beast ass running backs like a Leonard Fournette, let's get him. Whatever. And we still need to draft a quarterback, a backup for Stafford. And Paxton Lynch, is he looking like that guy? I don't know. Joey Bosa and Robert. And he had a better game to do from Ole Miss. Y'all know I can't say his last name. I'm not even going to say it. But he had a beast game yesterday for Ole Miss. There's a lot of good defensive talent coming out this year, though. So, as I said, we should go there first. I didn't get a chance to address the new Lions president situation, but I don't think it really matters because the president this time really will be mainly just business, just on the business side of things. He really won't even be touching the team. So that tells you right there the general manager is going to have a lot of fucking power, whoever we hire next. So this is going to be huge. Martha Ford, man, I mean, she's had a hell of a month right now, man. She's giving us two back-to-back wins. She's cleaning house. She's doing all things I ain't never seen this Lions franchise do in their fucking history. She's making changes left and right for the betterment of this team. And she did one thing this week that I really agree with. She got the Lions. I mean, I don't really listen to the Lions radio broadcast anyways. I'm always watching on TV. But she got rid of the partnership with the Ticket, which is Mike Vellini's station. And it was mainly because of Mike Vellini. And I said this, man. You know, one thing I didn't agree with was the control the Lions want to have over motherfuckers who speak ill about the team. Now, that's some bitch-ass shit. So I do agree with Mike Vellini on that shit. But I do agree that they should get the damn team away from his station because, he really does down talk the fucking Lions, but I think it was a good move, man. I mean, she's been making good moves, man, so. It is what it is, but let me wrap this shit up, man. It's been going long enough. I had a lot of clips in here, so didn't want to really talk too much this week. As far as this week goes, I might do a hate week. I'm not leaving town, you know, until Wednesday night, so I'll just be at the game, and then I'm going to fly back home. So I don't know if I do a recap on time, or because I don't want to do one too late. Nobody's going to fucking watch it if I do it like 2 days late. So, I might, you know, in between work or something. I don't know. We'll see. If not, it'll definitely, you know, if I do it, it'll be up on Friday. So, the next 2 weeks are going to be weird because it's going to be Thursday game. So, the next week, I'm staying in Detroit until Friday. So, I'm going to be there. I'm going to sleep, you know, I'm going to sleep over. I'm going to come in Thursday morning, sleep up, go to the game, fuck around with the bitches, and then I'm going to leave on Friday. So you're definitely not going to get one on time next week. But this week, maybe there's a chance, you know. So we'll see what happens. So like I said, I'm so glad to go to this fucking game, man. And I'm just glad to see fucking Lindsay and Yasmin, man. I haven't seen her. I met Yasmin at the Miami game last year, and, you know, she's been a good friend, you know, distant friend for me. I know she's happy to come back home to the D, so, just like me, so, Yeah, man. I mean, I'm so excited, man. And like I said, I'm just so glad to get past this fucking Raiders game, man, because it sort of stressed me out to kind of have to root against my team, man. But it is what it is, man. So, you know, I'm more glad that the Lions got the win, you know. And the Raiders, they can make the playoffs next year. I mean, they got a good young team, man. Good young team in the future. So, ain't nothing to worry about there. And, like I said, let's beat these fucking Sheagles, dog. Let's get them. Nice week, man. This win was for y'all, man. These wins, the second half of the season is for the Lions fan base. You know what I'm saying? So, shout out to all the One Prayer Riders, and I'll see y'all on the other side, dog. All right? Thanks, man, for watching. And all the new viewers, man. Thanks for watching. If y'all need a shout out, let me know, man. I'll shout y'all out in the next video. So, all right, y'all. Thanks for watching. Peace.
Raider Nation, JSRBC, it's that time again, let's get it going, from Brick City to Oakland, One Nation, silver and black, it's where we bleed, let's go. Yeah, I'm hopping on the flight now, I'm on my way. EWROAK. In about 5 hours, I'll be hopping off the plane. Can you please take me to the Raider game? I need to see silver and a whole lot of black. It's Raider Nation and we don't know how to act. Speakers turned up loud, baby, let it bang. I need to see you at the Raider game. Raider Nation, yes. We just gotta kick it. I see you at the game, man, I just got a ticket. I'm flying out of Newark, so I be getting in time for a 5-hour flight that land me 3 hours behind. Yes. My headphones knocking, plane tearing up the airway. You know what I'm rocking, all black and silver everything. Yes, make it to the stadium, you can see me pacing. Long time coming, I couldn't wait to see the nation. Can't wait to see my Raiders. No. We ain't the team you wanna play. And I ain't the fans envious, they know who truly run the base. Yes. They stay in the background, so they might as well hate. Enough about them, let's see what's popping at the tailgate. Yes. By the time the game starts, I'm screaming like an asshole. Yep. And I got the hookup, I'm sitting in the black hole. Yes. Better yet, standing. Victory, I'ma see that. At the Raider game, man, that's where you need to be at. I'm hopping on the flight now, I'm on my way. EWROAK. In about 5 hours, I'll be hopping off the plane. Can you please take me to the Raider game? I need to see silver and a whole lot of black. It's Raider Nation and we don't know how to act. Speakers turned up loud, baby, let it bang.
Let it bang.
I need to see you at the Raider game.
I need to see the super fans, I'd rather hang with them instead. Predator, Skull, Lady, Andrea, the dead. Cannon, Pain, Dr. Death, the fans are the finest. Dark Side, Wonder Woman, rest in peace, Pirate. Offense, defense, baby, we gotta show out. Opponents get no points, I need to see a blowout. Better yet, a shutout, tell haters to butt out. Something like a coupon, competition get cut out. Taking over the West with the mark of the beast. We crushing all of them, Broncos, Chargers, and Chiefs. And our quarterback is mobile, and he could be the prophet. We know he could scramble, but let's keep him comfy in the pocket. I need to see the wideouts line up in the splits. I need to see the Raider Rets drop into a split. The nation is all in, it's a stadium wave. This what it be when you see us at the Raider game.
I'm hopping on the flight now, I'm on my way. EWROAK. In about 5 hours, I'll be hopping off the plane. Can you please take me to the Raider game? I need to see silver and a whole lot of black. It's Raider Nation and we don't know how to act. Speakers turned up loud, baby, let it bang. I need to see you at the Raider game.
At the game, baby. Raider Nation. Yeah. JSRBC. Silver and black, it's where we bleed, baby. You know how it go down at the game. I love it. Oakland Raiders.